Once upon a time, on a Christmas Eve, all the family gathered together to celebrate. There were aunts, grandmothers, and grandfathers, and cousins by the dozens. Everybody was happy and gay. Forgotten were all the little fights and petty quarrels they had during the year. It was a wonderful time, especially for the children. Celebration began with the lighting of the gaily decorated Christmas tree. After waiting for what seemed like forever, at last the children were allowed to enter the enchanted room. There were all kinds of presents for everyone. Small gifts, medium-sized gifts, and very big ones, too. Countless wishes were coming true. For that is what Christmas is, and what it will always be. But there was something different about this Christmas Eve. There was a strange feeling in the air, yet only the children could sense that it was there. In their dreams and imagination, they could tell that something unusual was going to happen. They didn't know what it was, but a kind of magic spell came over their party. The magic seemed to start when Uncle Alex Hoffman entered the room. Uncle Alex always had such a stern expression on his face that many of the children were frightened by him. But little Marie and Tommy loved their uncle anyway. To them, Uncle Alex had magical powers, and so did the toys he brought them. Thus, under his spell, suddenly Tommy's little toy soldier came to life. Thank you. Tommy and Marie were swept away by the magical dance of the little toy soldiers. Strange Christmas Eve really began when Uncle Alex unwrapped his second present, the Nutcracker. His head and mouth were too big and his legs were too short, but something about him appealed to her. She wanted to take care of him and watch over him. Marie's cousins felt quite differently about the little Nutcracker. They thought he was ugly. They wanted to destroy him. Marie tried to protect him, but in the end, the poor little Nutcracker was broken. And so was Marie's heart. Now she loved him more than ever. And when her mother put her to bed, the Nutcracker went with her. She gradually fell asleep and floated into the land of dreams, the land where the bad are punished and the good rewarded, where those who are small and unimportant during the day change into shining princes, princes imagined only by little girls who love and defend ugly little Nutcrackers. Somebody waved to her from far, far away. Was that Uncle Alex? And suddenly a different Nutcracker was standing before her. A handsome Nutcracker whose body wasn't broken and whose mouth was not too big and whose legs were not too short. Then in her dreams, she saw herself more beautiful than she ever imagined herself to be. And with her beloved Nutcracker, she danced in unlimited space. was happening to her. She seemed to be under a spell. She felt light as air, completely weightless. And in some mysterious way, she and the Nutcracker traveled to the palace of the Snow Queen. Everything around her was fantastically glittering ice crystals and magically sparkling figures, such as she had seen before only in her dreams. The Snow Queen and the Snow King received them on their thrones with great cordiality, and they ordered all the snowflakes to dance in honor of Marie and the Nutcracker. Thank you. This time Marie knew she was dreaming, and what a beautiful dream it was. She also knew that she was in this dream thanks to the Nutcracker. He could not forget how she tried to protect him from her naughty cousins. So when the Snow Queen gave him a wonderful flying carriage, he asked her to come with him, and they set off for the land of sweets. From the beginning of time, the land of sweets has been governed by a beautiful and kindly woman, the Sugar Plum Fairy. Her country is full of happy and delicious things. Its rivers run with milk, its houses are made of angel cake, and its mountains are covered with white icing. Our friend the Nutcracker was traveling home to this land because he was not really a nutcracker, but actually an enchanted prince. And the beautiful and kindly Sugar Plum Fairy was his mother. It seemed that many years ago, his mother's deadly enemy, the King of the Mice, kidnapped him and changed him into a nutcracker. And ever since then, he wandered the world trying to find his way home, for only in his mother's palace could he again become what he was supposed to be, a prince.
Thank you.
they came across the strangest creatures. Marie was curious to see everything close up, so she asked the coachman, who reminded her a lot of Uncle Alex, to land. But don't think that everything was smooth sailing on this long trip. Sometimes the small carriage in which they were riding would bounce and rock dangerously. And one day, swarms of strange birds flew around them. Just a few at first, then more, and still more. And they realized they had arrived in the land of the bluebirds. Thank you. had to leave the land of the bluebirds. Marie urged the Nutcracker to continue his journey. After all, they wanted to reach the palace of the Sugar Plum Fairy as quickly as possible. But the palace was a long way off. They had to fly over many countries and over the seven seas, over great continents and oceans. And so it was not surprising that one day they found themselves in Arabia.
Thank you.
Then the end of their long journey was in sight. They had landed close to the palace of the Sugar Plum Fairy. Huge golden doors opened before them, and there was the road they'd been looking for all this time. As they came closer and closer to the inner rooms of the palace, Marie became more and more excited and thrilled. It wouldn't be long before they met the Sugar Plum Fairy, and with one breath, she would undo all the bad things that had happened to the Nutcracker. She was, right in front of them, radiant and beautiful. She came forward to meet them. She smiled and welcomed them. And the Nutcracker recognized his mother at once, and she knew him. The Sugar Plum Fairy changed him back into what he was before, a prince, and no evil power on earth could ever separate them again. It seems it's always at the most beautiful moment that our dreams come to an end. And that is what happened to Marie this Christmas Eve. She had to say farewell to the land of sweets and return again to her little girl's world. And what grown-ups would ever know what really happened to Marie and about the wonderful trip she had taken? Nobody. Except maybe Uncle Alex. Perhaps all of these mysterious events were actually his doing. Who knows? Perhaps again, even tomorrow, new dreams will be waiting for Marie, new princes and new fairylands, and maybe there'll even be another nutcracker.